celebrations has a lot to offer, from, you know, the chocolate fountain to the lights to the photo booth. I mean, you can just really have to work with one person and one company is really nice, because, you know, I'm sure the wedding, between all the different vendors, you can talk to a lot of people. So it's nice to kind of condense things that they're versatile and can do multiple options.
So what we've done here is we've set up this room to kind of look like a wedding reception and give you a couple different options of the things that we do. We talked about the DJ system and the lighting and the photo booths and some decor lighting, and all of it is can be seen right here.
Very cool. So I see it's kind of light up, pink and purple. Do you have different colors or?
Absolutely. We can change all of these different colors to really whatever color you want. We can match exactly what the colors you are. Now, some of the lights are doing different things, but we've set that up so you can see the different options of all of the different lights. We are what you would call a full-service event services company. So disc jockeys and MCs and photo booths and lighting and all sorts of amazing things that people need for any event, especially a wedding, is really what we do. We have a ton of help. I have a staff of over 12 people that take care of all of the logistics in terms of meeting with the brides and setting up the equipment and attending the equipment and being entertaining and being on and being the perfect host or hostess for that particular event that they're hosting or hostessing, or emceeing or DJing or photo boothing or chocolate fountaining or whatever. We do it the right way. We do it the right way, and we do it professionally, and we do it because we care.
So I went to Goodman Jewelers today to meet with John, and he was extremely helpful and knowledgeable about all of the jewelry and other products that they have to offer there. I looked at wedding bands for myself and for Brian, and definitely found some ideas and styles that I think could work for us.
Not only plain gold, but also some of the alternative metals that are popular today. And I'll show you a couple different variety of things that are real similar looking.
So what are the pros and cons between getting one of the alternative metals and the gold? I know that the alternative metals tend to be less expensive than the gold.
Right.
So what are the pros to getting gold?
The pros to gold are that down the road, if he ever needs this finger size change on a gold ring, he can do that.
Okay.
We can always size a gold ring larger or smaller. If somehow it gets damaged, it can be repaired. With the alternative metals, the size it is what it is. You can't change it.
Okay.
The cost is certainly a lot less. But if something happens, finger changes, knuckle gets jammed, things like that, life happens.
Yeah.
you have to actually get a different ring. So the wedding bands, we can find a lot of nice diamond bands that will go along and complement the engagement ring, because a lot of times the engagement rings don't necessarily come with a band. So we can find a diamond band that either curves around or fits below the design, so that it complements, doesn't take away from the beauty of the engagement ring. It works out real nice.
Blackhawk Country Club, obviously this is my second time going there after the bridal shower, and it was just as mesmerizing and beautiful as the first time I walked in there. It's just the atmosphere there. It just has this overwhelming awe of exactly what you want for a wedding. I've seen a little bit of this room. Now, where would you put the bride?
A lot of times folks have head tables, and that would usually be up on the window so that their back is to that view.
Right.
And that works out real well. Other people nowadays, a little different, want the table right in the middle of everything, and we can certainly do a round table right in the middle of the room for that.
And then, now for myself, I am gluten intolerant, so what kind of menu would you have for me?
Well, those kind of adjustments we make every day, whether it's vegan, vegetarian, gluten intolerant, you name it. We can make those adjustments. What we'd like you to do is come try some of our suggestions for gluten-free meals, and just pick the one you like. As far as timing of the ceremonies go, we ask that the ceremonies begin no earlier than 5 o'clock during the summer. That's so our golfers can still use the 10th tee. Then once about 15 minutes before the ceremony, we close off both ends of the cart path, so no golfers will be making their way through during the ceremony. They'll just play number 11 and then come back to number 10 at the end of their round. As the season goes on and we get into fall, we can start to open the tee a little earlier, beginning at 4 o'clock in September and 3 o'clock in October.
Today we went to Reedsburg, and the first place we stopped was LK Design, and I met Lindsay there. She showed me a lot of her photography that she's done of different weddings. She has a great new little studio. It was beautiful and has a lot of samples hanging up in there from all the different things that she does.
The initial package comes with what we call our rave book, and it is it's a beautifully printed book. The cover has two options. It can have an image wrap like you see here, and it can be black and white or full color. This bride just happened to choose black and white. And then it is a 90-page album that is traditionally bound.
Okay.
And this book actually showcases the overall wedding day. The next one is, or the first upgrade, is our I Do book. It's a similar idea as the Rave book, but it's got some upgrade features. This is our Ever After book, and it is probably our deluxe of our deluxe. It comes with 100 different cover options, so you can do different cover materials, you can do different image placing on the front. It's just a beautiful, beautifully bound book. It does have really nice, heavy-duty paperweight. If you want to spiel that, that's actually one sheet of paper.
Okay.
It has the highest quality digital printing available on the market. Beyond photography, we also offer custom design, and that includes designing your wedding album. Every album that we design is customized based on the bride and groom's vision of their wedding day. It includes the same colors you use throughout the bridesmaids' dresses, wedding stationery, and any other details that you actually included on your day. It includes any variety you had as far as accessories, flowers, anything like that to really enhance your wedding album to make sure it looks and feels like your wedding day did.
This is what Jen has really shown me, exactly what I need to do, the steps I need to take, and she puts it all together in an extremely user-friendly on a computer. So you just pick and choose. Okay, I want some of this. I want some of this. Okay, maybe I don't want this. I want this instead. And it's just the template that she has set up is so great that it really makes it very easy, especially if you're going to do parts of it yourself. But if you want to just have her go ahead and do the whole darn thing, well, she's ready for that too. I mean, she's just so very versatile that it makes this a lot easier and less overwhelming.
So the first step is your design, and by design I mean what's actually printed on any of the pieces of your stationery. So starting with the design, I can offer you a printable option, a print at home, a DIY is also called a DIY printable, and you can find a lot of the designs that I offer for these options on my side website. So not my main website, but my, you know, a little side DIY website under Printables by Jen. So just like Invites by Jen, it's Printables by Jen. I have sort of a separate division of Invites by Jen. I call it Printables by Jen. And what it provides is do-it-yourself printed at home files of customized invitations. I still do all of the design work, all of the customization with wording and that sort of thing. But starting with that DIY printable file, the client can then choose if they want me to print, if they would like to print themselves, if they would like to purchase some cardstock to cut themselves, or if they'd like me to cut it for them. And then we continue on with all the other things that they would decide to do if they'd like to do it themselves.
I met with Chris from Piano Fondue and Savvy Entertainment today as well, down on State Street. And he was a very entertaining guy. He explained to me kind of the services that they would have to offer for my ceremony and reception. So it sounds like it would be a lot of fun. And I've been to the Ivory Room multiple times before with friends. So I know they would
put on a great show and do a great job.
You can have live entertainers as your background music during cocktails and dinner, or you can have standard, our DJ do standard music behind that as well. Then the first dances usually are with either the DJ or the pianos, and then the pianos start the show and get everybody out on the dance floor, and then the DJ takes away after that and takes everybody all the way up to midnight. The show is an interactive show, so it's something for everyone. It's something for people just sitting in their seats, singing and clapping and having a great time. It's for people out on the dance floor, but it's not just a typical show. It's interactive, where everybody is part of the show instead of just sitting there listening to music. We're the only show that comes with professionally produced lighting and sound, so it's actually five of us that typically show up. We have two technicians, two dueling piano players, and one DJ. Typically, it's a nonstop show from the time of the first dance right on up to the end of the evening. We get to know you in the interview process of planning your event, and we get to know what kind of music you're interested in, what kind of music you think your family is going to be interested in, and they can probably have some input too. The evening of the event, we do take requests, but we use them as appropriate for the dueling pianos portion of the show. If you've seen the show, you know how very impromptu it is, so we use it as appropriate.
Brides and Bells is great. That was the first time I put on a dress, so Amber made me feel really comfortable, and I felt like they picked out dresses that suited what I was looking for, and even something I really necessarily wasn't looking for, but once I put it on, it felt right. Like they knew how to suit you and even gave you some ideas that I may not have been looking for. It was, I had really fun trying on different dresses and different styles.
So it's your first time shopping? You haven't gone anywhere else?
Yes, I've not tried any dress on. This is new, brand new. Nervous, excited.
Awesome, perfect. Okay, and information, we like ruching. That's great, some movement through the body. So you're thinking outdoors in Madison?
Yes.
So how we have things set up, we have our gallery down here. So it's just a little sampling of different designers, price ranges, silhouettes, okay. Fabrics, just a little sampling of it. So what we like to do is just walk through and you point out different things that you like or don't like about the dresses, and then I'll run upstairs and pull some. We are in our newly expanded Brides and Bells in beautiful downtown Reedsburg. We've got over 15,000 square foot of showroom space here. We do wedding dresses, bridesmaids dresses, mother's dresses. We have over 500 bridesmaids dresses, over 600 wedding dresses. We are a little bit of a drive from Madison, but we definitely have a lot of dresses here in the store to choose from. We are a full service bridal salon. We can take care of everything here in the store. We also do lots of recommendations for other people. If you have any questions for your wedding, even if it has nothing to do with your wedding dresses or your bridal party, just ask us. That's what we're here for. We've been in the business for a long time. We know a lot of the venues, a lot of the distributors. Anything that you would need, that's what we're here for.
I really like Badger Bowl. I really like that the room that opens up. I like that we can go watch some bands. I think my friends will have a really good time. And, you know, if we want some privacy in the beginning, we can shut the room. But then when we want to go dance with everybody else and have some fun and be in front of the band, you can go out there.
This is one of our newly renovated rooms.
Okay.
We call this the VIP suite. Well, this room can be made private as it is right now.
Okay.
Otherwise, this wall does open up and it is expandable. You can enjoy live music out in the bar, or we can close the room off to be more private and close the curtains.
Okay, that's really neat because it gives you kind of options of being part of the crowd or just private with your girls and kind of playing games or whatever you wanted to do.
Sure, it'd be great for that. Everyone likes to have a little fun with the bachelorette party. One of the nice parts about this room in the VIP suite is that it can be made private.
Okay, so I can bring some private entertainment if we want to.
We do allow private entertainment, yes.
Okay.
Like I said, we do sell fun here. That's part of the package.
That sounds like I got a lot of options here. I think my bridesmaids might have a little too much fun with that.
Oh, I don't know about too much fun, but
there never is there's never too much fun, is there?
No. In the last 10 months, we've made a lot of renovations here at Badger Bowl. We've made some cosmetic changes to our bar area, and then in our cabin banquet meeting facility, we've completely renovated the room. It now handles parties up to 165 people. And then, of course, in our VIP suite, we've completely renovated that as well. And that gives you the new look that you see behind me. Very comfortably, we can fit 30 to 50 people in our VIP suite for a bachelorette party. We have accommodated groups of up to 100 people. We do have a removable wall that allows people to spill out into the upper area of our main bar. So people can still have a lot of fun with a large group in there as well.
So today we met with Jim and Connie from Happily Ever After Officiants. They were both very nice, very welcoming. We met right in their home. That's what they do with most of the couples that they meet with to officiate their wedding. I really liked getting to know them, and it sounds like they really like getting to know the brides and grooms that they work with as well. They invite the couple to their home, kind of find out a little bit about the couple's history, how they met, how they got engaged, more about their personal life, so then they can incorporate that into the ceremony that they plan.
We're so glad that you came. We love it when people come to our house. We feel that it's really important for them to feel confident and safe, and they have trust that their officiant is going to do an absolutely perfect job for them. And we feel that you get a better idea of if we're able to do that if you come into our house and see who we really are.
We average around 60 weddings a summer, so we'll do 3 or 4 on a weekend, and there are 26 weekends where the wedding season is May through October, and we try to take some weekends off, and we don't do more than we can handle. We no longer do Friday weddings or Sunday weddings to keep things simple, and so we'll do usually on a weekend 3 weddings.
Mm-hmm. We almost never do them together. We usually each have our own wedding.
We limit our weddings to Dane County. When we were traveling to Milwaukee and Wisconsin Dells and Lake Geneva, it took a lot of time away from our couples when we were just basically spending time in the car. So we now just limit it to Dane County, and we love the venues we have here. There are many beautiful places, there are many beautiful parks, and our calendar fills up with weddings just in Dane County on Saturdays.
Larry was a very nice man, and he definitely was very knowledgeable about his different vehicles and what you can do, what kind of people he's had as clientele, and definitely gave me a bunch of different ideas of what I would want for my wedding, because I definitely would want something that's a little more shuttle service, but I'd also want something a little bit more personable, especially on the days that when we're getting ready. I really don't want everybody sitting here worrying about driving their own car and getting dispersed from the group. I've been looking forward to seeing your wonderful vehicles.
Well, great. This is the Hummer limousine, and let me show you what it's got.
Awesome.
Yeah, this holds 14 people, and we have some different size vehicles. The limo bus holds 20, and other excursion limousine holds 14. We have an 8-passenger limousine and a 10-passenger limousine. They're just regular stretch limousines. But they're very comfortable and they're very sturdy also. We do a lot of different things, you know, besides the weddings, but yeah, definitely. Most of them are fun things, so, all the drivers have a good time and make sure that the parties have a good time also. Our wedding packages start with 2-hour minimum, and we go from there, and we've done anywhere from 8 to 12-hour package weddings. We give you a price that includes a gratuity for the chauffeur, and that should be your price unless you go over the time that we quoted you for. So. Other than that, it's all an inclusive rate. We do put pop, ice, and water in all of our limousines for you. There are glasses and napkins for you guys to use. And each vehicle has a sound system, which has a DVD player, CD player, and an iPod hookup. So it's pretty well all set for you once you get in there and ready to go.
So walking in to Benvenuto's, it was lunchtime, so I think being a little hungry already, it was great because they were already starting to cook food and the smells were great. When talking with Sam, she had lots of different options. The full menu, there was just so many, seafood, there was pizza, there was pasta, there was, steaks, just lots of options. So it was nice when she brought out the menu options of just having a selected menu.
This space holds up to 40 people. We can do like 2 tables of 20 or 4 tables of 10, whichever works best for your group. If you have more than that, which some groups do, some don't, we just kind of start overflowing into like this table or the booth. So, it's as private as we kind of have. So semi-private is what I tell people, but it works out really good. We do a lot of large groups here. Our menu is very large, which can be a good or a bad thing. So for people that have never been in here, have never tried the food, we kind of help them pick the menu items that we think their guests would like the best. As soon as they have the date, we can reserve the space. In regards to details, as long as we touch base about a few weeks before the reservation to get the menu items locked down, any details that they want, that's plenty of time for us. We do a lot of parties, so we're really used to it, and our kitchen's used to the volume. But I always recommend, as soon as you have the date, just to at least lock the space in, since there is only one spot to really do a large group in here. We do supper checks up to infinity amount of guests that you have. So we just ask that you be patient with the servers, and then we always have people in the back helping them cash them out. But so we can do one check or separate, whatever works best for the group and their needs. We do parties like this. Like I said, every week we have at least one large group in here. So we're so used to serving and cooking for large groups. So I will offer recommendations for you and make it as simple as and concise as absolutely possible.
Jess and I both went and we tried some cupcakes over at Gigi's, and first off, the lady who was serving the cupcakes, the manager there, Lorna, she is amazing. And I just love the store. I love how cute it is. It's just got so many cute little aspects that it's just, you feel like the kid in the candy shop, and it's just, I love that because it's just exciting and fun, and you can't help but go there, get revved up with sugar, get all hyper, and well, it's right next to the mall.
Something we can definitely incorporate, we can change frosting colors, we can do different color sugars, we can get different colored sprinkles, we can really do anything to customize for you. So if there's anything that you see out and about, you say, hey, I'm going to pick this up, can I bring it in? We'll use it, not a problem. So we really will make your dream wedding happen. I mean, it'll happen. So then we go down into the tiers, and we have two different sizes there. We have a large square and a large round, and then we have a small round as well. The larger round and square are 5 tiers, and then the smaller one is 3 tiers. So depending on how many you're going to get, you kind of want to just judge on the size that you're going to rent. If you want to rent, you don't have to.
Okay.
You can choose to do something on your own, glass cake stands, or a lot of people with themes are doing, you know, if they're like a barn theme or outdoor theme, they're doing like boxes of wood or, you know, different things like that. It's hard sometimes to sell the gluten-free. Some people get a little, oh, it's gluten-free, but it tastes awesome. I love it. Our flour is just like regular flour, so it doesn't have a different kind of texture. It really is just like a regular cupcake. Gluten-free is really taking a lot of steps forward to becoming a good dessert.
I met with Josh at Be Cool, and he was really personable and definitely looked very genuine, which is something I look for in a DJ. Just being able to not have the basic cookie cutter, you know, I don't need the cha-cha slide, although I'll probably have it. I don't need a whole bunch of crazy mixes, but he definitely gives me a better chance of having exactly what I want.
Lighting is a big part of what we do. In fact, we do a large amount of uplighting that comes free with your package.
Okay.
That's kind of a rarity for wedding DJs in this market. And then in addition to that, we also have quite the substantial setup for our light show within like the DJ booth area as well. I use this more as a gauge to figure out what you guys are into. And then I use that in conjunction with what the guests are requesting, what people are really reacting to, the energy in the room, and I build my playlist on the fly. For me, it's a thrill to be able to go in and celebrate with a different crowd every weekend and kind of cater the party to that specific crowd, as opposed to just showing up and playing my general wedding playlist that I've played at, you know, 30 other weddings
right.
In the last year or two. So we've got a few pieces of paperwork that we will set you guys up with, one of them being the contract, of course. Contract is the main thing that covers most of the details. And then one of the other two items of paperwork that we put together, it's kind of a fun little thing that I set you guys up with to get a good idea of your musical taste. That's the wedding SAT. And wedding SAT, basically, SAT stands for Song Artist Test. Basically covers a few different sections and allows me to get an idea of what your musical tastes are.
I really love Kestrel Ridge. It's just gorgeous for being, you know, unknown. I didn't know about it at all, and it's only 20 minutes outside of Madison. It was just beautiful. The ballroom, I love the chandeliers. It was just like a dark wood in the fireplace. It just really felt homey and elegant. You can have your wedding outdoor there. You can just kind of do the one-stop shop, which I really enjoy, and I think that's a great option for people because it's hard to travel around. It was just outside of Columbus, which is only 20 minutes away, so I thought it was just a really good option.
Do you do weddings here too, outdoor weddings?
Absolutely, yes. We have a newly built gazebo outside.
Okay.
And you can fit as many people. We have quite a bit of grass space there to fit as many chairs and guests as you care to put out there. So it's kind of nice. We're a one-stop shop. We can do your bridal shower, bachelor parties, rehearsal dinners. We can have the ceremony right here. You can come right in to have your reception. Most people like to do a little cocktail hour, some wine and appetizers, and then go into to the reception, and you can wrap it up the next day by doing your gift opening right here also. Madison has a lot of wonderful places, very beautiful places, and you know, due to supply and demand, they certainly charge a heck of a lot more than we do. We're very reasonable for what we offer. We're only 20 minutes from the east side of Madison. It's a very short drive. And there's also accommodations here in town if people are concerned about traveling. Many people rent party buses, so they come pick up your guests at midnight and get everyone back safely.
So I haven't ridden in the White Plain for about 6 weeks, and I was kind of missing it. I like now that it's color changing. It's almost like a chameleon. It's starting to turn a little darker, rusty as we turn into the fall. So the rust and fall colors are coming out in the White Plain. It's not that summer white anymore.
The Lone Ranger is coming out soon, and the White Flame just kind of reminds me of like just that quintessential stallion that, you know, where it's like, oh, we're off to go on some fun-filled adventure, and do here's the White Flame, and you're off to go. So it's like earlier this morning, it was Jessica even mentioned, she's like, oh no, jump in the White Flame, come on, we're off. And kind of like, you know, just where kidnappers would just come and sneak you and throw you into their truck kind of thing. It was kind of like that this morning.
We also realized that the White Flame has like a no smoking sign in it, but it's kind of ironic since the White Flame is always smoking, is what we decided.
If the White Flame was a rock band, I think it would be Poison.
Really, we need to do something about like actually pinstriping some flames on there.